I'm Amanda Nobles with Kilgore Economic Development Corporation, and welcome to the peer-to-peer roundtable.
We developed a 320-acre business park site several years ago. We did not go through a certification process, but we were successful in marketing that.
And we opened a 705-acre business park 2 years ago, our second park in Longview, and we are in the process right now of certifying that 700-acre park.
We have a business park that started out in the first phase at about 350 acres that we bought in the late 90s. We have expanded that to 450 acres.
The state of Texas or TEDC or whoever wanted to certify those and put those certified sites on a website, that's one more website that your site.
Buyers and on site, is the site accessible by all points? If not, our alternate access points clearly defined?
Things early on, we did some homework with some consultants that we knew sited large projects around the state, around the country, and asked some advice.
There's three things that they definitely have to have, and that's the clear ownership, the utilities, and items relating to being developable, like the environmental, whether or not it's in the wetlands or endangered species or anything of that nature.
A lot of our smaller communities really can't afford the big type of certification. I would hope that we will get to the point where we do have, at least for our state, a consistent list of here's what you need to have, and here's what we're recommending that you have as a minimum.
You have a new site or a site that you're looking at buying or something, get some best case practices from some of your other colleagues. Call around. We're all willing to help.
Okay. Thank you very much for participating. We really appreciate your attendance at this, and those of you over at the tables, thanks very much, everybody. Thanks our panel, too.